let us lose.
Rich pickings. And the crew.
Up in the fodder.
Keep the both of Egypt busy.
Try to flank!
Can't do this alone.
finish.
Give me a hand over here. Give me a hand!
The spoils of war!
Union for your relief.
I'll kill you.
Got it.
Watch for my signal.
I'll stay our welcome.
This.
Let's have a song.
If you have a friend, one that's truly trusted, and want good to grow your friendship, often should you
let the sound
now. I must be careful now.
Thank you.
with me. Watch my leg.
Brothers, let's end this.
From me, with me, here!
should we see there? A hunch of work. What have you discovered?
Bridge were swarms with guards, reinforced from the river. Word is that two of Fulke's finest oversee such matters.
We should kill these leaders and burn their ships. Crippled and put to panic, their men will be in no place to join Fulke at Porchester.
Frightened men look to their own interests. A good plan.
Okay.
one to go. The other should be near the boats.
On my way.
I should return to our camp.
No raising the sail here.
Hey! Cut it out!
Interesting.
So shining blade, like wolf teeth they brightly glitter. Now the time for bravery calls us. Fearlessness shall mark our. The fields with thunderous
cut into you.
Sunan.
Eivor has returned! Hail, Vulkist!
And so violence begets violence. An eye for an eye, as the good book says. But soon we will all be blind.
Not quite. Whoever makes the last strike shall still have one eye left.
In the Street of the Blind, the one-eyed man is called the Guiding Light.
Does that holy tome of yours have a quote for everything?
Eivor, forgive me. I have slain too many of my own people already. I cannot kill more. I must return to London.
And you, Erki? Do you feel the same?
Someone has to keep an eye on him in the big city. He would only get himself killed otherwise.
We took this camp together, so I will ask no more of you. Return home, and let your friendship be a beacon to our peoples.
Godspeed, Eivor. I pray you come back safe.
Birsten, I'm glad to see you again. How is your family?
Alvida keeps my...
And...
I hear store... I have brought...
That is...
Fight hard.
When have I done...
Quite the agent of chaos. Fulki's men are chasing their tails, not knowing where you will strike next.
Poor Chester has neither the supplies nor the forces to keep us out now.
And you have bought time for your allies to arrive. Many have come, not least the bishop here.
As I promised. As the keeper of God's word, it would be poor form if I did not keep my own.
Now, if the talking is done, there's blood to be spilled.
Eivor, dark news. We found a letter on one of the dead. Fulke has called for aid.
Reinforcements.
A Saxon army marches from Winchester.
Then my men and I will ride to meet them. We will harry them every step of the way to buy you time.
We may begin the assault at once, or you might wish to speak with your allies, if you've not done so already.
Warm words do thaw the chill of battle fear.
We march. When the sun sets on this day, Sigurd will be returned to us, and Fulke's head will be on a spike.
Let us begin.
Eivor, did you enjoy the gift I left you in Canterbury?
You will die today, Fulke. But your men may live if you come here to me and settle this alone.
We have nothing to settle. Die on these walls if you will. It is your choice.
No wall is high enough to keep me from you.
Then come. Claim your brother if you can. I shall wait with him. If you would find us, you need only follow his screams.
Fulke!
What will the Skalds say when they speak of this day? They will say we unleashed such rampant slaughter that Odin himself stirred on his throne to watch. They will say that ravens blackened the sky to feast on Saxon dead. So raise your swords with me now, brothers and sisters, for today is the day we carve our names into legend!
I'm coming for you, brother.
So many battles and so few scores, Basim. What's your secret?
Don't give heat.
Aha! The simplest strategies are the best.
Clear the way! Let's take down that palisade!
All lends me strength.
Come on.
The cube is in sight! We must find our way to it!
You!
stronger already.
Some slack bladders. I know Sigurd must be close. Up these stairs.
Sigurd was here once, but no longer. Where has Fulke taken him? Is this Sigurd's blood?
Still fresh.
Sigurd! Every instant of your torment, Fulke will suffer tenfold.
The church! Fulke must have taken him there! Come on, Batten!
Face us, Fulke! Your cowardice betrays you!
Sir!
inside, the idiot!
This door will need the strength of two!
You'll be gristle! Get back here, coward!
Eivor, some help?
The church! Fulke must have taken him there! Come on, Batten!
Face us, Fulke! Your cowardice betrays you!
Try to flank!
door will need the strength of two!
Hey, come here!
Fulke!
I have done all I could to help him, Ava. The rest is up to you.
No! No! Brother! Brother! I'm here for you. I have you.
Let me stay with him. You deal with Fulke.
I'll come back for you. I promise.
Cower from me, Fulke, like a rat in the dark.
We're all in the dark, Ava. It is the search for the light that brings us closer to the gods.
Save your babble. Death is our language now.
You fight beneath the banner of ignorance, Ava. I could pull back the curtain for you, give you a glimpse of what lies beyond.
I need nothing from you. This ends here.
The bits to kill one with such potential.
Where are your fine words now, Paladin?
If you will not raise your eyes to the light, I will bury you in the dark.
So you can fight after all.
You meddle in matters you do not understand. Like Sigurd, then you know. Do you not wonder, Eivor, at the things I have learned?
Every word you say is madness.
Sigurd is an ancient one, an Archon, Nephilim, Isu, call him what you will. He is reborn.
He is my brother and my Jarl, and you are mind sick.
He is everything we should hope to be.
Fulke! Damn you to hell! Fulke! You can't run from me forever! Nobody touch her. She's mine.
You are too late, Eivor. I have opened your brother's mind to the truth. That is my victory. And you will go with me to the grave.
Thank you.
flesh, but my work will live on for all time.
Okay! You can't run from me forever! Nobody touch her. She's mine.
You are too late, Ava.
And...
flesh, but my work will live on for all time. We are. Spit and vomit. Shit and soul. Sigurd is so much more. I gave him that understanding. That gift.
You gave him pain!
Yes! To awaken him!
Was the
great work. The highest achievement of humankind. Now you, Eivor, you must carry it forward.
See you guys.
Me walk.
Sigurd.
Eivor. I will fight. As a thresher through a field of wheat, mad one.
What has she done to you?
Eivor! We delayed them as long as we could.
Reinforcements from Winchester have come.
Get Sigurd to a boat. I'll hold them off till you're safely away.
Fight well, Eivor. Find us at the settlement when you can.
Archers! To the walls!
Is that the last of them?
We have beaten them back for now, but without Guthrum's army, we do not have the numbers to hold this fort.
We found Sigurd. That is what matters.
Guthrum was hasty in his judgment, Eivor. You are fit to stand with the best of us. Go to your brother. The words of one beloved will heal him faster than herbs. I will see to matters here.
May the gods guide you, Uba. Until we meet again. So, Mayalskonna, it seems we have won.
A great victory. Not even these walls could stand against us.
This land will be ours in time. What now for you?
Uba and I will go west, driving the Saxons before us. Alfred will not hold a crown much longer.
I hope one day to see you both there.
I would like that.
Birsten, your ram was invaluable in breaching this fortress.
A trifle in comparison to the great service you have rendered me.
You will have a good story to tell Alvida upon your return.
There is that. But battle is not so thrilling and...
How did you like the taste of battle?
That was... exhilarating! Reminds me of my younger days.
Had you not delayed those reinforcements, we might never have succeeded. You're brave for a priest.
Do not underestimate the faithful. We give our lives to a god we cannot see.
I should speak with Hytham. Sigurd Jarl, back where you belong. Oh, I missed you, my brother.
Yeah, you missed me.
Yeah.
Once or twice, I hear.
What?
You took your time to find me. Was it for this? To enjoy your time on my throne?
I did only what you asked of me.
And you slew all those who questioned you.
That is not what happened. Randvi will tell you.
Oh, yeah. We'll see. My dear wife. Brought to me as a gift by her clan to pacify my ambition. Yes, I'm sure she will be the one to tell me the truth.
What did that witch, Fulke, do to you?
You cannot even begin to imagine the things I've seen. What I've learned. Born of gods is who I am. A lord of war. A Roman Mars. I know who I am. I know my destiny. And you will not hinder me!
Brother.
Forgive me. I am faint. Tired of the day and all that has passed. I need air.
He's been this way since his return. Could you speak with him? Settle his mind.
I can try.
Stand with cheer, one and all. Today is a day of celebration. Our Jarl is with us. Tonight, let us drink and eat in honor of his return. And now, I will delight you.
Basim, will you not join us?
In time, I may celebrate. But tonight is a melancholy mood. I would rather sit here quietly alone.
I understand. Where is Sigurd gone? The Wolfgar! So glad to see you.
A new composition of my own.
Show me. Cemetery. His mood is dark. What are you doing here? I was looking for you. Sigurd.
Dark died defending my honor?
So he claimed.
But it was... My honor needs no defense. It is stone solid. Unblemished.
I offered him a way out, but...
Shh. Say nothing more of the past. It is gone. There is a rift as deep as death between then and now. I was tested, Eivor, in a crucible of blood and fire. And in my agony, I was reborn. You may think me less than I was, but this is not so. I am greater than before. My mind is a wellspring of prophecies, visions that tell me who I truly am. And for all that, I am grateful for my suffering.
Sigurd, I want to understand, but all this, all you say makes little sense.
Basim saw these things in me. Fulke, too. Despite her cruelty, she spoke the truth. I am more than the man I was.
more than this hobbling stick that stands before you. You must look harder, Eivor. Deeper. See for yourself what they found in me. Do you see it? My greater self.
I don't know what that means.
Look. This is the face of a god.
I see only my brother and my truest friend returned to where he's loved and cherished, where he's meant to be.
You're kind, but your eyes are clouded by the past, a place I can no longer see. I fear our paths diverged long ago. Go. I wish to be alone. Return to my feast and drink for me. Celebrate the days to come in my name.
Now it seems the wind calls me back to Randvi. Let's tell her the good news.
Good to... What happened yesterday? You and Sigurd disappeared during the feast. And when he returned, he went straight to our room without a word.
We talked for a time. I asked many questions, but got few answers. I wish I could say more.
Do you think Sigurd knows? About us?
I don't think so. He would have said something. Sigurd wants to blame me for every mishap that has befallen him, but gives me no credit for his rescue. I don't understand.
Yet he does speak with you. With me, he has gone totally silent. So, what now?
This is for Sussex. We burned it to the ground to save one man, yet he is barely the man we were searching for.
Quite so.
I want to see the Alliance map. What about Lincolnshire?
A rather boisterous man named Hunwald arrived recently, wishing to speak with you. On a matter of great importance, he said.
Where is he now?
Down at the docks, carousing with my scouts and scaring the fish from the river. He waits for you with great eagerness.
He sounds charming. I will meet him at once.
Protect your ears.
I'm grateful to see Basim returned. There's so much more I wish to learn from him.
Keep this. It serves your cause better than it does my pocket.
Another one? You are certainly proficient.
As a token of my deep gratitude, I want you to have this.
There is more to be done, Eivor.
I have to go.
Then go in peace.
You may think this odd, but our lively chatter here has inspired in me a short poem. May I recite it for you?
Go on, Lord the Boy. Make me...
Oh! Another skald come to join us.
Me? Oh, goodness, no. I'm no... Shall I continue?
I'm not here to judge your...
Yes. I have come with the hope of meeting a...
Every warrior in this clan deserves a song or saga, Lord.
Why? Because his name alone...
What's your name, Lord?
I am Hundwald. You see, my father is ailing. Only a month ago, with I know not...
Outcast from your...
Could one of your clan march beside...
It may be we can help you. But we'll want something...
And you shall have it. My father is a great friend of the Danes, in spite of the recent wars.
You sing a sad song, Hundwald of Lincolnshire. A son, robbed of his father's protection, now desperate to prove his honor. How far will you go to regain it? To a bloody end?
Oh, indeed. I will plunge into the heat of battle to defend my father, knowing our cause is a righteous one.
All right, young lord. My clan has need of me just now. But when I'm ready, we'll find your father together and right the wrongs you've suffered.
Ah, you are the chieftain here. I suspected as much. God praise you, Eivor.
I won't be leading you into the heart of the shield wall, but there will be danger. I want your word. You will follow my orders to the room.
I am yours to abuse.
If it comes to that.
From there, we shall make our way to Lincoln.
Goodbye, Lord Boy. Safe travels.
I fear maybe it's caught.
That might shut it.
Let us sweat together, bleed together, triumph together.
To me, warrior. Let gold and glory be our meat and mead.
What are you doing?
Eivor.
Surveying the area, Sudan.
This is Humboldt's safe haven.
Humboldt, who is this stranger?
Eivor, come, sit.
And ale, please, alewife. I have been discussing my delicate situation with Alvgar here.
Lord.
He is a nobleman like me, one of Lincolnshire's sturdy thanes. Hunvold's idea of sturdy is a mug of ale that won't tip over. Alvgar has pledged his loyalty to my family, the House of the Ferocious Swan. With his influence and your might,
We shall rid Lincolnshire of the ruffians who plague this land, once and for all.
We are going to see your father, Hunvald, that's all.
Indeed, Eivor. With speed and purpose, you are the axle to my wheel, the spark to my tinder.
Hunvald, your father's ill, and your enemies have every advantage under the sun. Do you have a plan, or have I come all this way to watch you drink this watery piss?
Of course, my friend! I am a man of action above all else, ready to leap and dance and fight!
Listen, I've come to escort you to your father's side. We go now, or I walk.
Ah, yes, to Lincoln! Away! But with care. The road between here and there is teeming with brigands who wish me dead.
You daft lump of lard. A single Dane will not protect you against the whole of Mercia's army.
I think you're wrong, Alvgar. And here he'll prove it.
I'm hot for a fight, Snowdog. Give me half a chance, I'll stove your heathen face right in.
All right, a quick brawl to get familiar with the local dregs.
Won't think twice about it.
Nothing welcomes us more into the day than a swift bruising.
Is this what it means to be your friend?
We shall triumph, Eivor. We shall win this deadly round.
Hunvald, don't want...
Clear out, all of you, before you kick up a fire.
Jesus, my bones are aching. Could use a dip in the sea.
Shut your hinge, Chael, and stop dripping blood in my hall.
Told Hunvald to stay near. Where did he wander off to?
Did you hear that scream? Sounded like Hunvald. He went out that side door.
Drink it all, rocks. Step off! You'll see for yourself.
Hunvald is in trouble.
Read the word.
I'm even beat.
Jesus! He's brought a bloody day!
I have been struck down, bruised within an inch of my life, but I will survive.
I must
continue as you would, Eivor. And if I should expire, avenge me.
Strike with me! God, this end. He's paying us. Fear got your belly, dog.
I live! I am alive! Heaven have mercy!
Are you hurt?
Unbelievable! The Battle of Bottlefston will be remembered for years to come! Alvgar, we have won our first great victory!
Hunvald, are you hurt?
Never better,
We should get to Lincoln as quickly as we can.
Yes, yes, you're right. Let's depart. What horrible souls are hunting me? Me, the son of a beloved elderman. Was it naive of me to believe my status as a nobleman held some sway over the chaerls and serfs of this shire? What cause have any to dishonor me? Look! Boats there! We could sail the waters to Lincoln, sink the ships of any enemies in our way.
What were you told when the guards exiled you?
Oh, scraps of nonsense. I woke to screaming. A man grabbed me, said I was an immediate danger to my father. Horse pucky. Mercian soldiers then shackled me, rode me blindfolded to the River Wash, and told me plainly, start anew elsewhere or face death in Lincolnshire.
What did they mean?
Oh, some nonsense about me praying for his death, hungry for his inheritance.
Speak plainly, Humboldt. I can't help you if I don't know the full story. You hold no grudge against your father?
No, never. No, I suspect the order for my exile came from on high. Perhaps one of Burgred's final orders before he was deposed.
That would surprise me. Burgred was battling Danes until the end. He had bigger things to worry over.
Perhaps you're right. He's too contained. It must have been King Alfred, then.
King Alfred of Wessex? That's another kingdom entirely.
Yes, but Alfred has a fearful hatred of the Danes. He must have heard that I am courting one. A beauty who knows no equal.
Your Dane lady love. Right.
Here's Lincoln, the city of my birth.
Best raise my hood here.
Present sorrows.
Mercian guards everywhere. Follow me.
I can continue. Right behind you, Shadow Walker. My heart beats like the drums of your dragon boat.
Sawyddu Avras yma.
Meet your fate! You'll sleep! Intruder! Come on!
This town was your home?
It was.
There's damp on the air. I fear great crowds will gather soon.
Fills my eyes with tears.
Save weeping for prayers. We're not inside yet.
One day I won't have to skulk around this town with my face hidden. I will walk proudly among the people I love. Oh, how can a place I once called home be so fear not, Lincoln. I shall make you mine again.
Thank you.
Hunwald! Praise God, you live! I do, my dear Reaganhair. Body and soul. Tell my father his son has returned and in fighting form. It is urgent I speak with him.
I'm sorry, Lord, but your father has been taken.
Taken? When?
Weeks ago, Lord. And well ill he was when they carried him off. I wish I could say more.
Who took the Elderman? Was it soldiers or men of God?
There were men with swords, and those of the cloth. And a healer, too. One who had oft been a guest in this house.
Galwina. One of the sisters my father put great faith in. He still has friends in Lincoln. That's a good sign.
Bishop Herivrith among them. He's kept a vigil at the town hall, looking after things in your father's absence until he returns.
Will we find trouble there? At the town hall?
You mean soldiers and the like? Aye. There have been many men...
Right. We'll find... Who was that fellow?
Reaganhair? He's an old fixture of my family's household. Loyal to the end. He helps run the place. And he's known me since I was but a little lordling.
No one has
a
heard
simple
from the
fellow,
Elderman
but
weeks.
Worth every
What's
pinch
happened?
Of his
sword. Lord Nebior is surely dead. You go to death!
No, that can't.
The market is flush with goods.
Yes, it must be. Growing up, we never wanted for anything in my father's home. Bread, poultry, and field fruits of all manner. I suppose this is where our servants purchased them. Lincoln's boon was ours as well.
How often did you leave your house, Hunwald?
Oh, from time to time.
Hey, what?
To town. Yes.
Thank you.
Archer, Herevrith, tell Lord Hunbeorg his son has returned.
My lord, you're well.
Lord Hunward, you should have sent forewarning of your return to avoid the violence that dogs you. Lives might have been spared.
Why so surprised to see my...
Oh, worse than dead.
I have no patience for insult and rumor. We have come to speak with Lord Hunbeorg, that is all.
Lord Hunbeorg has gone, I'm afraid. He would not say where to, but I'm sure he will return shortly. Once the storm has passed.
What on earth do you mean by that? What storm?
Your father feared for his life, Hunwald. In his weakened state, he could not defend himself. Not against a Dane, certainly.
How dare you? Eivor is above reproach.
See this from my view, Hunwald. You arrive after a strange absence, with a hired Viking in tow, demanding to see your father. This does not, in my estimation, imply benign intentions.
If I meant to murder you, these stones would be slick with your gore already.
Such violence. Good heavens. God must have purpose for you pagans in his holy plan, but I confess to utter bafflement.
Hunwald, your father was at my hospice for a time, but he left of his own accord, without saying a word. That's all we know.
Come, Abbess. We should leave this young lord to his scurrying thoughts. There is nothing more of use we can say to him.
Take care, my boy.
Stay within these walls where you're safest. I'll have a look around, see what I can learn about your father.
If my father spent time at the hospice here, the healers who work there may know something. Talk to them if you can. Find out what they know.
Fecit Dominus Noster Sapiens Nubus, vide collecta supra in terra atheres.
Hunvold's father was recuperating here not long ago. Someone may have seen him depart.
Do you know where your alderman is?
I can tell you a few things, but not here in the open. Follow me.
Where's the alderman? Did you see where he went?
I don't know. Alderman who? Sorry, I'm busy.
Are you the head sister here?
Aye. And I'm not too comforted by the sight of you. It's bad enough I've...
No harm will come.
I'd be risking my neck telling you anything.
Your elderman would agree.
That's a pleasant thought. Our lord, then. Quite against mind, there's no work in Batha.
Ruins.
I pray you find him. He's in desperate need of care.
Ich wollte dann sehen.
If you ask me, what choice do we have? At least this way, they'll leave us be.
They killed one of their own. What's to stop her from splitting our skulls as well?
Because they fear us, see? No one takes us for fools. You got it.
Remember, God punishes those who wish ill upon...
Go on.
These tunnels run deep. Was the Elderman fleeing to a hideaway beneath Lincoln?
More Mercians traipsing across our routes. Can't piss from here to Bolingbroke without someone demanding some ungodly deal.
All this traffic has made smuggling a difficult job.
Smuggling will always be difficult. I prefer it to paying tribute. Never again will we bend to the Mercian crown.
Let's see.
Thank you.
body was picked clean and valuables taken. No effort to cover the tracks. Bandit work, no doubt.
I was fighting here.
About what?
A violent struggle between nobles and bandits. Bandits didn't fare so well. Noble's cloak with the image of a swan. Looks like the Alderman passed this way. Useful if I had a door to match it. Saxon noblemen paid some bandits for permission to sneak through these tunnels on their way to Bolingbroke Castle. Mercian nobles made a deal with some bandits, paid them hush money to let them sneak through these caves. When the time came,
The bandits ambushed the nobles. But it didn't end well for the bandits. In the struggle, the Elderman's cloak was torn off. But he got away and headed east for Bolingbrok Castle. That's my best lead. Best not to draw attention here.
Your doom, Corbin! Not a topic you need knowing about.
Thank you. up.
I'm on the right track. That keep is well protected.
I wonder what in God's name we're here for. Sunveil is his own prisoner.
Leave it to
Watch
me.
My lead!
Yourself as a true born king, born in a time of wolves. You have earned a long rest.
Thank you, beautiful girl.
There now, my lord. All is prepared. Shall we begin the washing? Hey, who comes? Welcome, stranger. Are you here to pay tribute to our Lord Elderman?
This biscuit has been dry for some time, sister. How long has the Elderman been dead?
Dead is such a drastic word. I like to think of my lord as transformed.
That's not untrue.
Have you need of anything?
Unvault deserves to know the truth about his father's fate. He is owed an inheritance, and deserves a chance to become Elderman himself.
All in good time, I imagine.
No, now.
When the guards put him in my care, I was told to keep all this a secret. Until the appointed time. When I asked who gave these orders, they struck me. I wish I could say more.
I've seen all I need to, but Hunvald will need proof.
Of course. You're welcome to search through his effects, though I'm not sure what trinket would best serve your purpose.
I'll find something. A box of musty clothing, and a brooch with a crest. The house of the ferocious swan. This will do. I'll return this brooch to Hunvald and Lincoln. I hope the poor boy can withstand such ill news.
Dried herbs and berries, crushed into powder.
The time between my lord's departure and his burial is longer than usual. My lord must keep up appearances for his upcoming rites. Bring it on.
Foul. Rat droppings everywhere.
Even in death, my lord is a friend to all of God's creatures.
If to harbor my throne.
I don't know what this is, and I'd rather not ask.
Yes. I thought the same. Troubling.
It yield they will swara. I can see soon, Huru. Silver is yet then, Kire. Ne beheld na. It yield ne ill the thou harvest. None other than the good harvest.
Take care.
And you. I shall take you to your family crypt at Nettleham within Lincoln. There, you may lay beside your forebears. The old Lindsay. Please, do not desecrate our lord.
I'm a Dane, not a cruel griefmonger.
Haben this name. Heist? You wish?
If they see me, this will get messy.
Magna voce teatrale canes belli tubini.
Elephas monus wunderlich. He micht.
Eivor! What news?
Your father's dead.
Wait, what?
The sigil of Hunbjörth's house. I found it near his body.
No. No, this cannot be. He was strong, a pillar of Lincolnshire. He cannot be gone. He...
Oh, you poor boy. I'm so, so sorry.
I am a man, Archer. Do you hear me? I am a man and I am my father's son. Do not forget it.
Keep steady, Hunwald. You're now the head of your house.
Another swan takes flight. Only I remain, last in a line of dwindling nobles.
I'm sorry, Hunwald. I had already asked a priest to administer last rites when your father disappeared.
What?
I didn't tell you sooner because I thought by some miracle he had survived.
You lied to me!
You silly, sobbing mooncalf. Will you never grow up?
Lord, have mercy on that woman. She should have said something. It was her duty to say something.
Hunwald was the son of an elderman. Will he take his father's seat?
The title's not hereditary, but he can plead his case before a shire moot. King Ceolwulf must then ratify the decision.
Explain how this works, your shire moot.
A moot is a meeting of lords. We convene from time to time to steer the course of our shire.
It was always my intention to convene a moot, but between our troubles in Lincoln and the bandits' raids, we slipped into a pattern of convenience.
We have a similar custom, what we call an Althing, an assembly of good folk.
With so many like habits, there should be peace between our people and yours. Perhaps that begins now.
Apart from Hunwald, who else will stand for the Elderman's seat?
If I may be so bold, I should like to put my name forward. Under my care, this Shire has found some peace this past month.
I will offer my name as well. My family has ancient ties to this land. And I am proud to say I have forged quite a friendship with the Danes to the north.
Good. My priests will spread word of the moot across the Shire, and we'll convene in a few days' time.
Do visit my estate, Eivor. I have something for you. Something I think you'll enjoy.
I'll find the time.
Eivor, a word, if you don't mind.
Is the word Christ or pagan?
Oh, I deeply regret my churlish ways when we first met. I did not treat you as my God commands, with kindness and love.
Love is a difficult feeling to command.
Yes, quite. In any case, thank you for putting this mystery to rest. I do hope we'll see you at the moot.
With Hunbjolf's death an open secret, Hunwald's enemies may strike again. I should find him before they do.
Archer went to console him. I should follow her.
Archer, where is Hunwald?
I tried to console him, but he pushed me away. I love the boy, I do. But I fear what would happen if he took his father's title. He's fragile and scattered. I saw him ride north, following the paved Roman road, to the old tall tree where he often passed time with his father, I imagine.
Hunwald loved you like family, and you lied to his face.
In my way, I was trying to protect him. Oh, Saint Cuthbert, give me strength.
Oath and ale work better than your prayers and saints.
These woods, Father.
all these woods. I remember the days
what
we
spent.
What
do you see, Sunan?
Here, upon this spot, ducking and hiding through the rushes with...
Eivor, what a pleasant surprise. Would you drink with me?
Hunbald.
Come, sit. Stay with me a while and contemplate... Contemplate the view.
Collect yourself, Hunwald. There's many a man in Lincolnshire who would pay to see your head on a pike.
Well, they can wait a moment.
Do not gorge on grief, nor give in to sadness, but let your aching love light the mead of your eyes and lead you to triumph.
That is quite lovely. My father would have liked you. He liked all those who could swing a sword and speak a verse with ease.
He had a large heart and a love for his people. I think I would have liked him too.
He and I used to wander up this way all the time. He would take me hunting, and I would catch the most wretched little things if I caught anything at all. I was a rubbish hunter. But he always said he was proud. Each and every time.
A toast. To your father, Lord Hunbeorth of Lincolnshire. He may have dwindled from this world in death, but in life he was as stalwart as this tree.
A wise old oak. Yes.
Skull.
Skull. And then my father says it's the right goat, but it's the wrong end. Oh, my Swanborough loves that one. She has a great sense of humor, my lady love. Father would have liked her.
Right, your Dane lady love. She sounds lovely. Too lovely to be real.
You know what? We should visit her. We should go to Grimsby. Yes, there's no time to lose.
After you.
Nothing like drinking and riding to jostle your troubles away.
And the contents of your gut.
Now come and enjoy the splendor of my shire.
You Saxons and your tiny splendor. You've never seen mountains, have you? Or deep fjords like a giant's axe wound. Or towering falls that steam in the dead of winter. Snow sparkling like a blanket of jewels. That is splendor.
Well, if your homeland is so splendorful, why come to England at all?
You can't grow crops on a blanket of jewels.
Very true.
I'll admit, your countryside, dust